מכות, page 15. We will start with page 14b, two lines from the bottom of the page. אמר רבא בר בר חנה, אמר רבי יוחנן, כל לא תעשה שקדמו עשה, לא קין עליו. So, because, as we learned yesterday, the whole idea of חיוב מלכות, receiving a punishment of מלכות, applies על לב הניתק לעשה. So, which means if someone he is in a violation of that negative commandment, he is in the chiyuv mitzvah daseh. For example, we have in Pesach the prohibition of lo tatiru, which is all the korban Pesach, the paschal offering. The Torah said lo tatiru mimenu ad boker, you should not left over until the morning. So if someone have it over, so the Torah said va'anotar mimenu ad boker va'esh tisrofu, whatever left over you should burn. So there's a machloket if one receive malkot if in violation or not. So therefore the idea is you should not say it, do it, but if you do it, you do something else and then you exempt from punishment. So Rabbi Bar Bar Chana, Rabbi Yochanan said, even according to those Tanaim that hold that the person not receive malkot over lav hanitaf kleaseh, so he said, kol lo ta'aseh shekdamo aseh, when you have any type of prohibition that precedes by a aseh, by a positive commandments, so a person receive malkot for violating the prohibition. So the whole idea of not receiving malkot, for example, when we have one is in violation remedy by a positive commandment, so that's not applied if that positive commandment applies even without violating the prohibition. So there's a book called Birkot Shamayim, and in that book he hold the Hagaha indifferently. We said Shenatana Katuv. So basically, if you hold that way, so it's a that there are those who hold that one does not incur Malkot for violating such a prohibition. But you see, the Aruch Laner questions whether there are indeed any who hold this. He brings the several commentaries that say that it's lav davka. There is a Pnei Yoshua. There is a Gvurat Ari. There is several mefarshim that do not go in this direction. But anyway, we just go by the pshat, by the way Rashi explained. Page 15, Amru lo, so they respond to Rabbi Yochanan, others that heard that ruling on his behalf, they said, Amar ta, this is what you said, Amar lehu lo. So and basically by saying no, it means that he retracted from his view, and he said that you not receive malkot over lav shekdamo le'aseh, that you see also in the Tosfot. Hochlaner asks a question, is that possible that Rabbi Yochanan exaggerated the truth here? Why didn't say clearly that he retracted, retrieved his word? But anyway, Amar Rabba, Rabba Seha Elohim, that's a language of oath. Amara Uchtiva, Rabbi Yochanan did say it, and it is written. It's a positive commandment, and it's written in the scripture. Vetanina, ktiva vayishalchu min hamachane, velo yatam'u et machaneim. So the pasuk said, and they shall send out the camp, every tzarua and every zav. So you have here a positive commandment that the Tameh leave the temple domain, any place that is Machane Shechina, Beit HaMikdash, and also as a positive commandment to take away Tmeim from Beit HaMikdash, Tanina, we learn the Mishnah, page 13, Haba LaMikdash Tameh, the one who entered the temple domain while he is in a state of impurity, even though he can still perform the positive commandment to leave the temple, but still receive Malkot. Why? Because the mitzvah taseh of shiluach tmeim, of sending away those who ritually impure, precede the mitzvah of velo yatam'u et machanehem. Ritva have two explanations why it's written that way. Anyway, Ela Maita Maka Hadarbi. So why Rabbi Yochanan's original ruling he retracted? Mishum de Kashiale Ones, because he have an issue with a case that Ones, which is a typical case of rapists. The Tanya, we learn in the Braita. Ones Shegirash, someone who rapes a virgin. And then he married her. So he married her following the Torah law in Dvarim 22, verse 29. The Torah said, Velo tiyeh leisha. So if he divorced her, so he is in violation of the law. Lo yuchal leshalcha kol yamav. Im Yisraelu, if he's not a Kohen, so he can have her back and he can fulfill the mitzvah of Lo tiyeh leisha. Machazir, he returned her, ve'inoloke, because he fixed, he rectified the mistake, the sin that he committed. Im kohenu, kohen prohibited to have divorcee, so therefore he cannot have her back, loke, because he is in violation of the negative commandment, ve'ino machazir, cannot have her back. Im Yisraelu machazir ve'inoloke, amai, lo ta'aseh, Shikdamo asehu. This is basically a negative commandment. Is a yeah that positive commandment preceded. Since the positive commandments for the rapist to marry her applies even initially, not only after he marries and then divorces her, so then velilke. So he should receive Malkot. So because Lo ta'aseh shekadmo aseh, you receive Malkot. So that's because of this kwashia, because of this problem, Rabbi Yochanan retrieved what he said. And he said that you not receive Malkot, even Lav shekadmo aseh. Ula responded, he said, Lo ye'amer, lo tiyeh leisha be'ones. So the Torah should not say it, that she shall be a wife unto him when it's come to a case of rapist. Ve'ligmar, we learn the chiyuv to marry those whom he raped from Motzi Shem Ra, Mimotzi Shem Ra, who is a defamer. How you do it? With the Kal Vachomer. Because he turned that he lied and it wasn't truthful. Uma motzi shem ra shelo asa ma'aser marachmana velo tiyeh leisha. Ones lo kol sheken. If someone is defaming character. The Torah said she has to be his wife. Someone was a rapist. How much so? So lama ne'emar. Im inyon inyan lefanav. Tneu inyan lacharav. Shim geira shiachazir. So velo tiyeh leisha, it's a lav nitak leaseh, it's exempting for malkot, and he can fulfill the mitzvah of velo tiyeh leisha by have her back. So the Gemara asks, ve'akati, still ones mimotzi shem ra, lo gamar. דעיקה למפרח, למוציא שם רע שכן לוקה ומשלם. because Motzi Shem Ra in Kor Lashes and pay monetary penalty. Ela lo ye'amer lo tiye li'isha b'motzi Shem Ra ולגמר מאונס. ומה האונס שאינו לא קרום שלם? אמר רחמנה ולא תהיה לאישה. מוציא שם רע לא כל שכן. ולמה נאמר? אם אינו עניין למוציא שם רע, תנה לו עניין לאונס. אם אינו עניין לפניו, תנה הוא עניין לאחריו. ומוציא שם רע, מאונס לא גמר. דיקה למפרח, מה לאונס שכן עשה מעשה? You can say, מוציא שם רע, that he speaks, he defamed the character. But it's only a uttering of words. So you may think that the Torah is not hold the same level of strictness. So ולא תהיה לאישה, you can say that the pasuk need for itself. אלא לא יאמר, לא תהיה לאישה במוציא שם רע. שהרי אשתו היא. The Torah said, לא יוכל לשלחה כל ימיו, that it's his wife. ולמה נאמר, אם אינו עניין למוציא שם רע, תנה לו עניין לאונס. ואם אינו עניין לפניו, תנה לו עניין לאחריו. So it means if one is in violation and divorced her, so he have the mitzvah of have her back. And that's basically asay natek et alav. So it means if you have her back, you're exempt from malkot. Ve'im ha'i ve'im eno inyan lefanav de mutzi shem ra, tnei inyan lacharav de dey de lo laki. So the Gemara said, ein achinami, ein achinami, ve'at eones, ve'gam meir minei. So therefore, memed is the truth, ve'lo tiyeh le'isha. Nevertheless, in case of a rapist, they comes in and derive from the case of defamer. The same way as a defamer who divorces his victim avoids malkot by remarrying her. So the same way as a rapist who divorces the victim avoids malkot by remarrying her. במאי גמר מיני, אי בקל וחומר במה מצינו. אי כאלה מיפרח כדי פרחין על מה למוציא שם רע שכן לא עשה מעשה. אלא אמר רבא, כל ימיו בעמוד והחזר. כל ימיו appear as a superfluous, as no need. So it means that even a divorcer, he can have her back. That's עמוד והחזר. וכן חיית הרבין, when רבין came from Eretz Yisrael to Babel, he said, אמר, on behalf of רבי יוחנן, כל ימיו בעמוד והחזר. So רב פאפה, challenge the original words of Rabbi Yochanan. Lav shekdamo le'aseh, you receive malkot. Amar le Rav Papa le Rava, v'halo dam le lav ed lav dechasima. We have the lo tachsom shor bedisho, that we have the derivative that one receive malkot in all different loving. Amar le'i mishum dechatav berachman aseh teira migra gara, because the it is less of a prohibition because the Torah wrote regarding it an extra positive commandment. So you see here the prohibition that has a positive commandment associated with it is no less severe than ordinary prohibition and therefore remains punishable by Malkot. As the Gemara said, Yachi lav shenitak la'aseh nami. לאימא משום דחתיו ברחמנה, עשה יתרה מגרה גרה, because the Torah said it, a extra positive commandments. So our Papa argued and he said that this principle, that one does not incur malkot for committing a transgression, that remedy by positive commandments. So that's the idea, יתרה מגרה גרה, prove that the addition of a positive commandment does detract from a prohibition's or malkot's liability. Amar lei hahu lenatukei lavu de'ata. That positive commandment, in a case of transgression, remedied by a positive commandment, since it can be fulfilled only after the prohibition violated, comes to remove the prohibition from the ordinary remedy of malkot, and make the positive commandments its remedy. Anicha leman amar bitlo velo bitlo. So Rava said, and Ravin, it's follow the one who says that the Baita, it's from the idea he nullified it, and he did not nullify it. So for Rava and Ravin, said that someone who's a rapist, who divorces his victim, has, quote unquote, all these days to avoid Malkot by fulfilling the positive commandment to remarry her, as we said earlier. Ela leman de amar, by the one who said in a braita below, is to amend it and read, kimo velo kimo, he fulfilled it and he did not fulfill it. Mai ikale meimar, how would you say that all these days you have this amod ve'achzer, because the moment he come before the bed din, they right away require him to have her back. Otherwise, you receive immediately malkot. So how come you say that he will be le'olam all his day be'amod ve'achzer? Page 15b, midi hu ta'ama ela le'Rabbi Yochanan. So the reason that Rava and Ravin giving to explain the position of someone other than Rabbi Yochanan, because Rabbi Yochanan said that lav shekadmo la'aseh, so you receive malkot. So here you have a situation of a rapist that he divorced her, so he machzir ve'ino lokeh. So that's basically, that's the whole reason that it's called Lav Nitak Le'aseh. Amar Rabbi Yochanan Letana. It's one of the Amoraim, that Boki, that is erudite in all those oral brightot. Tnei bitlo chayav velo bitlo patu. Said that obviously if he have bitul aseh, so he receive malkot. Otherwise not. So there's a teshuva from the Beit Yitzchak. Beit Yitzchak discusses someone is a rapist, and the Torah said lo yuchal shalcha kol yamav, that he needs to keep her forever. Now, what happened if he decided that, let's say, they decided that 10 years passed by, they have no children. So does he allow to divorce her if it's that a violation of lo yuchal garsha? This is the teshuva from the Beit Yitzchak. The Tane Tana Kamed Rabbi Yochanan, kol mitzvat lo taseh sheyesh ba kum aseh, kiyem aseh sheba patu, bitel aseh sheba chayav. So Amar le Rabbi Yochanan said, maika amart, kiyem patu lo kiyem chayav, bitel chayav lo bitel patu, Nei bitlo, velo bitlo. If he nullified, so he's liable. And if he did not nullified, he's not liable. So in a sense, you will say both part of the rule determines malkot. So in terms of whether or not, he has nullified the corrective positive commandment. So Reish Lakish cholek, Reish Lakish disagree, Rabbi Shimon Lakish omei kimo velo kimo. So kimo is exempt, it is not fulfilled, it's chayev. It's all depend upon the ese. So it's a teshuva from Neidoni Rabbi Yehuda. It's also the Tzemach Tzedek. The teshuva was a crazy husband. And he used to come home and he'd scream and yell, and those days hit her. And it's amazing teshuva. So they said it to reach a point that she was really in such a situation that he blamed her for being unfaithful and was always angry. So one day the neighbors have rachmanus on her. So the neighbors advise her and tell her, you know what, if he keep blaming you all the time that you are not faithful, tell him it's true, I'm not faithful, let him divorce you, and that's it. So one day he came and he was screaming and yelling, the husband said that she's not truthful. So she said, yes, what you said about me, I'm not faithful to you, is true. So right away, next day, he took her to the Beis Din. And he said, you see, she admitted, and he divorced her. Short time passed by. And all of a sudden he heard from the neighbors that it was all set up, that she was faithful to him. But because of his terrible behavior and because of the advice of her good neighbors, she did it. So he come back to the Beis Din. And he said he wants to have her back. So, האם מותר לקחת בחזרה? Can he have her back? Why? He said, אני גירשתי בגלל שהאמנתי. I divorced her because I believe that she really admitted. So the Noida Biuda said, נשארת אסורה, that she remained prohibited to him. He cannot have her back. Even he claimed that it was amatla, it was, in a way, it tricked him. But the Noida Biuda rules that the case is over. Anyway, it's an interesting teshuva. במאי כמפליגי, בהתראת ספק כמפליגי. What does they argue? They argue regarding an issue of an uncertain warning. מר סבר, which is רבי יוחנן הולד, התראת ספק שמה התראה, that uncertain warning is considered a valid warning. ומר סבר, which is ריש לקיש, said, התראת ספק לא שמה התראה. That uncertain warning is not considering warning. So he cannot hold the view of Malko depends on whether he nullified or he did not nullify it. Rather, he must hold that the view that Malko depends on whether he nullified it or he did not nullify it, which does not presume that Malko can be given on the basis of uncertain warning. So I'd like to conclude with a Dvar Avraham. Dvar Avraham bring a big chidush. Said it was two britot in one day. One was a case of a baby that is bezmano, that the baby is really the 8 days old, and they need to do the bris milah, the bris on time. Was another baby that by force of circumstance, hepatitis infection, she was too yellow, whatever it is, postponed. So the question is, what take precedence? So Dvar Avraham argued, based on our sugya, said that the whole idea of making the brit at the 8 days earlier, it's hidur mitzvah. It's a beautiful thing, but it's hidur. Zrizim makdim le mitzvot, vigilance, does the mitzvot earlier. But he argued and he said the moment that the baby passed the 8 days, the other baby, every second, it's basically you have the chalot mitzvah, you have the obligation to do it right away. So he argued and he said, no, first you do the baby that's already past the time, and the push come to shove, the hidur mitzvah, so not do it right away early in the morning, do it a little later on the day. But since the one already passed the due date time, in a way he argued it's much urgent than the others. That's a beautiful chidush of the Dvar Avraham.